guys, welcome to my channel. I am Ram. So in the previous videos we saw about profit and loss concept as well as simple interest compound interest concept. So in this video we are going to see about time and work. Okay, so this is also one of the important topic that you need to cover in order to clear your aptitude test with respect to campus interview, or it can be a government competitive exams like IBPS, RRB, SSC, whatever it may be. So this is also plays an important role in your aptitude preparation. Okay, so please give some attention and give some time in preparing for this concept in a detailed way. So let's see what is time and work concept. So this whole concept, time and work concept, revolves around only one simple thing. Okay, so if someone says that Ram can finish, that is, can complete a work, it can be any work, in for say x days. Okay, so if Ram can finish a work in x days, then he will take, then in one day he can finish 1 by x of work. Okay, so this is the only one basic concept that the whole time and work concept revolves around. Okay, so if you are familiar with this concept, you can crack all the questions related to time and work. Okay, so what is that? Ram can finish a work in x days, then he can finish 1 by x of work in one day. Okay, in one day he can finish only 1 by x of the work. Okay, so in other words, if someone is saying Ram can do 1 by x of work in one day. So they are saying that Ram can finish a work, finish 1 by x of a work in one day. In one day, he can complete 1 by x of the work. Then how many days he will take in order to complete the whole work? I mean, in order to complete the entire work. Okay, so in that case, he will take x days. Okay, so if he is taking x days to complete a work, then in one day he completes 1 by x of the work. So if he is taking 1 by x of the work in one day, then he will take around x days to complete the whole work. Okay, so this is the simple concept the entire time and work revolves around. Okay, so I hope you are familiar with this concept. Let's see a few sums related to this so that you will get a glimpse of how aptitude questions will be asked in this concept. Okay, so let's take a question. Says that the first question says that Vinod can do 25% of a work. Okay, they are saying that Vinod can do 25% of your work, of a work, in 5 days. So they have said that he can finish a 25% of a work in 5 days. How many days he will take to complete the work 10 times greater? Okay, so they have said that there is some work, and they are asking us to find how many days he will complete 10 times of that work. Okay, so they have said that they have given a clue that 25% of a work can be finished in 5 days. Okay, which means that 25 divided by 100, so we are taking the percentage, so we are it's given in percentage, so we are converting it into fractions. Okay, so 25% can be written as 25 divided by 100. So he is we can cancel this. So 25 fours up, so he is doing 1 by 4th of the work in 5 days. Okay, he is doing 1 by 4th of the work in 5 days. So actually what he is doing is he is completing 1 by 4th of the work in 5 days. So in one day he is completing 1 by 4 divided by 5. So he is completing 1 by 4th of 4th of the work in 5 days. So in one day, for one day he will complete 1 by 4 divided by 5. What I am doing is I am dividing the total work for 5 days, so I will get the work done in one day. So I am dividing it by 5, so obviously I will get, so I can go back, I can revert this, so I will get 1 by 20, right? So I will get 1 by 20. In one day, who is that? Vinod. Okay, so in one day, Vinod is completing 1 by 20 of its work. Okay, so it will take obviously 20 days to complete this work. What I said, 1 by x of the work can be done in x days, right? So obviously it will take 20 days to complete that work. So it will take 20 days here, 1 by 20, so 20 days. So Vinod will take 20 days to complete that work. So single work can be completed in 20 days. Okay, now they are not asking that one, they are asking that in how many days he will take in order to complete a work 10 times greater than that of. Okay, so here he is taking only 20 days to complete that work. So the work assigned to him now is 10 times greater than this. So 10 into 10 times greater, so he will take around 200 days. Okay, do you get the concept? So what I am doing is, it's 25% for 5 days. So I am dividing it, 25% I am converting it percentage into fractions, that is 1/4, 1/4 in 5 days. So in so they are given as 1/4 in 5 days, 1/4 of the work in 5 days. So in 1 day he will, in order to find how much work he has done in 1 day, we are dividing it by 5. So he has done 1/20 of the work in 1 day. So if he is doing 1/20 of the work in 1 day, it will take around 20 days to complete that single work. Okay, so now they are not asking about that single work, they are asking us to asking us to find the number of days in order to complete 10 times greater than the actual work. So we are multiplying it by 10, so we are getting 200 days. Okay, so this is one of the simplest problem. The only thing that we need to remember over here is 25%. Okay, we are going to convert 25% into fractions. So we are getting 25 divided by 100 is equal to 1/4, and we are dividing it by 5 because it's been done for within 5 days. So we are getting 1/20 for 1 day. Okay, so that's that. So let's move on to the second problem. A can do a piece of work in 20 days, B can do it in 15 days. Okay, so they have given us A can do a work in 20 days, B can do your work in 15 days. Okay, and how long will it take if both of them work together? So they are asking us to how long it will take in order to complete the work if they work together. Okay, so if they work separately, A is taking 20 days and B is taking 15 days. Okay, so we can say that A is completing 1/20 of the work in 1 day. Okay, we can say this because in 1 day he is completing 1/20 of the work, because he is taking 20 days in order to complete the whole work. So in 1 day he will be completing 1/20 of the work. Okay, we are getting this right. So that's what will be the B's completion in 1 day. B will be completing 1/15 of the work in 1 day. So in 1 day B will be completing 1/15 of the work. Okay, so they are now they are working together. Okay, so now they are working together. So what we are going to do, we are going to add them both. Okay, we are going to add them both. Okay, so that we will get now the amount of work they have done in 1 day. Okay, so we are going to take LCM for this and we are going to add it. So 20, 15, so 5 table, 5 4s are, 5 3s are, then we will be having 4 1, 4 3, so 3 4s are 12, 12 5s are 60. So 60, so we can have 3 plus 4 divided by 60, it will be 9 divided by 60, so we can cancel it by 3, so we will be having 3 3s are, 3 2s are 20. So we can cancel this again, so 3 1s are, then 6.6. So we can say this as in one single day they are completing around 6.6 of the work. Okay, 6.6 of the work. So in order to know what is their how many days they will take to complete the whole work, we are just going to do the same, that is 1/x of the work can be done in x days, right? So here 1/6.6, so it will take 6.6 days to complete the work. Okay, so this is simple as that. So we can take this answer like this, as well as we can go in fractions as well. So if you want to go in fractions, that is also fine with me. So depending upon the options, you go by fractions or you can go by decimals as well. So this is how we have converted, we found how to find the answer when two of them are working simultaneously. Okay, so what we have done, A, B, then we have found what is the work done by each in one day. So in one day, A is completing 1 by 20 of the work, B is completing 1 by 15 of the work. We are just adding them both. So when we add them both, we are just taking the LCM and we are just cancelling it. Okay, so this is what we have done. So that's that. So it's very one of the easiest problems. Let's move on to the second one. Okay, so let's move on to the third sum. A can do a piece of work in 20 days. He works at it for 5 days. Okay, so he can finish a work in 20 days. So in one day, he will be completing 1 by 20, 20 of the work, okay, and he works at it for 5 days, okay, so he is working for 5 days in that project. So 1 by 20 into 5 days, okay, in one day he is completing 1 by 20 of the work, so he is working in that particular project for 5 days, so 1 by 20 into 5, and then B finishes it in 10 more days, okay. So in how many days will A and B together finish the work if they are working simultaneously? So B is again, he completed around 1 by 4th of the work, okay. He have completed 1 by 4th of the work. So that the remaining work is done by B, okay. The remaining work is done by B in 10 days, okay. The remaining work is done by B in 10 days. What is the remaining work? The remaining work is 3 by 4, okay. In a whole work, A has completed 1 by 4th of the work. So the remaining will be 4 minus 1 divided by 4. It will be 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 of the work is done by B in 10 days. Okay, in 10 days. In 10 days, B has completed the work, 3 by 4 of the work in 10 days. So in one day, B would have completed 3 by 40 of the work, right? Because we should divide 3 by 40, we should divide 3 by 4 by 10, okay. So you have completed 3 by 4 in 10 days. So in order to find the amount of work B has done in one day, we have to divide it by 10. So while dividing it by 10, we will be having 3 by 40, okay. B will be 3 by 40. So in one day, A is doing 1 by 20 of the work and B is doing 3 by 40 of the work. So now they are going to work simultaneously, and we are going to find how long they will take in order to complete the work when they work simultaneously, okay. So the 1 by 20 plus 3 by 40, right. So we can take LCM of this. So 2 plus 3 divided by 40, it will be 5 by 40. So 8 tables, so I mean obviously 8, so 8 days. So if they work simultaneously, they will finish the work in 8 days, okay. So why I have taken 8 days, 1 by 8, so 8 days, because 1 by x work can be done in x days. So here 1 by 8 of the work can be done in 8 days, simple as that. So we have also seen the third problem. Let's move on to the fourth one. So in the fourth one, they have said that Subhash can copy 50 pages of the book in 10 hours, okay. Subhash can copy 50 pages of the work in 10 hours. Subhash and Prakash together can copy 300 pages in 40 hours. In how much time can Prakash copy 30 pages? So they are asking us how much time Prakash will take in order to complete 30 pages, okay. So we need to know how much time he will take in order to complete 5 pages or 10 pages so that we can compare it, okay. So but they didn't give what is the what will be the amount of time taken by him, okay. So let's collate what are the things they have given. For the first one is Subhash can copy 50 pages in 10 hours, okay. So Subhash can copy 50 pages in 10 hours, okay. So he can copy 50 pages in 10 hours. Obviously then simple logic, in one hour he will be copying 10 pages, right. So in 10 hours he is completing 50 pages, so in 1 hour he will be completing 5 pages, okay. So together Subhash and Prakash together completing copying 300 pages in 40 hours. So together they are copying 300 pages in 40 hours. So obviously in 1 hour, again this is 55 pages in one hour, again we are going to find for 1 hour they can copy around 40 divided by you can cancel this 2, so 37.2. so 7.2, okay, so 7.2 pages in 1 hour. So if they work together, they will complete they can copy 7.2 pages in 1 hour. Okay, Subhash alone can copy 5 pages in 1 hour. Okay, so obviously we can see that we can substitute this, right? So Subhash in 1 hour can copy 5 pages. So 5 plus Prakash is equal to 7.2 pages. We are just equating it. Okay, so in Subhash alone can copy 5 pages. So I am substituting in Subhash place, I am substituting 5 pages plus Prakash. They are completing 7.2 pages. So obviously Prakash is completing only 2.5 pages. I mean, this is not 7.2, this is 7.5. Sorry. So 30 divided by let's say 4, right? So 4. So what if some 8s are 2, then I will be having 5. So 7.5 pages, the remaining will be 2.5. So Prakash is Prakash capacity is 2.5 pages in 1 hour. Okay, so Prakash can copy 2.5 pages in 1 hour. So Prakash can copy 2.5 pages in 1 hour. They are asking us to find how much time Prakash will take in order to copy 30 pages. Okay, so 30 pages. So in 1 hour, he can copy 2.5 pages. Now, how to find 30 pages? Let's just divide it by 30 divided by 2.5. So 30 divided by 2.5, it's nothing but 300 divided by 25, right? So 4 into 3, 12. So 12 hours. So Prakash would take 12 hours in order to complete in order to complete 30 pages. Okay, so in order to copy 30 pages. Okay, so that's that. So it's just a simplification. Okay, there is nothing more in this problem as well. Just logically think. So Subhash can copy 50 pages in 10 hours. Okay, so you can copy 5 pages in 1 hour. Okay, we are just dividing 50 by 10. So in 1 hour you can copy 5 pages. Similarly, Subhash plus Prakash together can copy 300 pages in 40 hours. Okay, so logically in 1 hour they can copy 7.5 pages. We are just dividing it by 300 by 40, so we can get 7.5, right? So 7.5 pages in 1 hour. They together working together, they can complete 7.5 pages in 1 hour. So in 1 hour, Subhash can complete 5 pages. We are substituting in Subhash place. We are substituting 5 pages. So P is equal to 7.5 minus 5. So 7.5 minus 5 will be 2.5, right? So that's simple. So 2.5 pages in 1 hour. So Prakash capacity is 2.5 pages in 1 hour. So they are asking us to find how many hours will be taken by Prakash in order to complete 30 pages. So we are just dividing 30 divided by 25. Okay, I mean 2.5. So we are getting 12 hours. Okay, so this is also one of the simplest problems. Let's move on to the next one. So the next sum, this is the final sum and quite quite challenging as well. Okay, so let's see what is challenging in this. So they have said that Apurva can do a piece of work in 12 days. Okay, so Apurva, let's take AP. So Apurva can do a piece of work in 12 days. So in 1 day, she can do 1 by 12th of the work. Okay, and Apurva Amit can complete the work together and were paid rupees 54 and 71 respectively. So Apurva is paid 54 and Amit is paid 81 rupees respectively. How many days must they have taken to complete the work together? So when Apurva plus Amit work together, how many days they will take in order to complete that work? So simple as that. So here what the problem is, we don't have any other clues in order to find what is the capacity of Amit. Okay, so in previous problem we had a clue. Okay, we had a clue. They said they can, if they are working together, they have copied 300 pages in 40 hours. That's the clue over there. So here we don't have Apurva and Amit's clue. They haven't given any other clue in order to find what is Amit's work. Okay, so capacity. So we need to find what is Amit's capacity so that we can apply this, we can add their work together and we can find the days. Okay, but we know only Apurva's, we don't know what is Amit's. So we need to find Amit's But the another clue they have given is this, that is 54 and 81 rupees. Okay, so usually when you think when they will pay you, okay, so if they are paying you more, they then you have done few more works extra than the other person. Okay, so here 81 Amit is getting 81 rupees, okay, which is obviously greater than Apurva. Okay, so Amit has worked, has done more work than Apurva, right? So this is the reason why Amit is paid more than Apurva, right? So because Amit has done more work, okay, depending upon your work the wage will increase. If you do more work your wage will increase, if you do less work your wage will decrease. Here his wage has increased, so he has done some more work than Apurva. Okay, so this is the concept. So we can say that your work is proportional to, is equal to your salary, right? Your work is proportional to your salary. So we can say that work is proportional, right? Proportional to your salary. Okay, here they have given this here the salary is 54:81. Because that's the clue that we are having. The work done by Apurva is 1/12, and we don't know the work done by Amit. Okay, so let's take it as 1 + x. Okay, so what is 2. So we are taking the ratio of it. We are comparing it. Basically, what we are doing, we are comparing the work with the salary they have been paid. Okay, so this is what we are doing. We are just comparing it. So when we compare this, we can, this is the ratio, right? So we can divide it. So we can say that 1/12 divided by 1/x is equal to 54/81, right? So we can cross multiply it. When we cross multiply it, we will be having 81/12 is equal to 54 into 1/x. So we can calculate this easily. We can take x over there, so x will be 54 into 81. So we can cancel these two, we can cancel it by 9 table, 9 9s are, 9 6 are, then we can cancel again it by 9, I guess 3 table, 3 3s are, 3 4s are, then 3 1s are, 3 2s are, then 2 4s are 8, so x will be 8. Okay, so what is x? X is the amount of work here. So x is the amount of work done by Amit. So Amit is taking 8 days to complete the work by himself. Okay, so he is taking 1/8 of the work in all, 1/8 of the work, he is completing 1/8 of the work in one day. So he is completing 1/8 of work in one day. Okay, so now what we are going to do is that we are just going to use the same method that we have used for the previous sum. What we are going to do, we are just going to add it. So 1/12 + 1/8. Okay, why we are adding? Because we are asking what will be the time taken by them in order to complete the work when they work simultaneously. Okay, so they are working simultaneously, so we are going to add it. So what will be the LCM for this? 12 divided 12 8, so 4 3 2, so 2 3, so 8 8 + 8 3 = 24. So 24, so 2 + 3 / 24 = 5 / 24. So we can say that 24/5 days, so it will take around 24/5 days to complete the work. So we can make it into decimals or fractions, whatever it can be. So I'm going to make it in decimals. So I can say that 4.8 days. 4.8 days. So if they work simultaneously, they can complete the same work in 4.8 days. But if they work, separately, it will take 12 days to complete for Apurva, and it will take 8 days to complete for Amit. Okay, so this is also one of the simplest problem. What is the striking thing that we need to remember is that this area, that is 54:81, the salary, the wage they have given to given for completing their work. So you have to know this thing, this concept, that is your wage is proportional to your work that you have done. Okay, so your work you have done in one day is 1/12 and 1/x, and the weight that you have gotten for that is 54:81. Okay, so this is what the whole sum depends on. Okay, so if you figure this out, you can figure what is the x, and if you figure what is x, you can just want to add it, and we have to calculate the number of days. So simple as that. Okay, so now we have seen what is time. Okay, time and work. So we have seen 4 problems related to that. So in the next video, we are going to dig more upon time and work. So we are going to see about what is efficiency, pipe problems, things like that. So please watch the next video as well. So I hope this video is informative. If you like this video, share to your friends so that they will also get benefit of it. If you have any other queries, let me know in the comment section so that I will clarify you that. Okay. So thank you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.